Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this channel, watch the video till the end. And also, if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. So today we have a topic with us. It's called the time Excel function. Now there's this function called date and time Excel function in Excel. In that, there is a function called time function. So we are going to learn this topic in a very detailed format. So let's begin. As you can see here with the example part, directly we are not going to move to the example, but I'll try and make you understand the time Excel function. See, the Microsoft Excel time function is a function of Excel which is, you know, built in, and it allows you for creating time with individual hours, minutes, second components. So these time function in Excel is helpful in assembling the proper time. I mean, it is categorized under, you know, the date and the time function. See, the time in Excel will return a decimal value that is between 0 to 0.9988426. So given in an hour, minute, and the second value, let's make it more clear. The value 0 will represent 12, and the value 0.99 will represent 11.59. So the time function in Excel is a worksheet function. It can be used as a part of the formula in cell of a Microsoft Excel worksheet. If you start with the time function here, you'll get hour, minutes, and seconds. Now let me give you an explanation. The formula of the time accepts the following parameters. You just write time, you'll say hour. So this can be any number that is between 0 to 3 to 7 6 7. Now which represents the hour. The point to be noted for this argument is that if the hour value is larger than 23, it will then be divided by 24. So the remainder of the division will be used as an hour value. For better understanding, the time 2400 will be equal to time 000. And time 25 over here, 00, means time 100, and so on and so forth. In case of minute, this can be any number between 0 to 3 to 7 6 7, so which represents the minute. Like for this argument, you should note that, you know, if the minute value is larger than 59, every 60 minutes will add up 1 hour in the pre-existing hour value. So for better understanding, like time 060 will be equal to time 100, and time 120 will be equal to time 200. If in case of seconds, this can be any number between 0 to 3 to 7 6 7, which represents the second. Like for the argument, you should note that, you know, if the second value exceeds, let's say, 59, then every 60 seconds will be 1 minute. We know it, and the time pre-existing minute value. Like for better understanding, time 0060 will be equal to time 010. We all know that's 1 minute. And time 00120 will be equal to time 020, and so on and so forth. So let's understand the usage part. See, the time function in Excel sheet is used for creating a date in serial number format from our minute, second component, which we use to specify. So the time sheet is used to create a valid time. So if you have the above component value separately, for example, time 300 is equal to 3 hours, right? And 003 is 3 seconds. 830 is equal to 8.5 hours. So once you get the valid time, you can easily format it as per your time requirement. Now, how to open the time function in Excel? You can simply enter the desired time formula like this in the required cell to obtain the return value of the argument. You can manually open the time formula in the Excel dialog box. Open here, and you have the time formula here in Excel dialog box in the spreadsheet, and enter the logical values to obtain the return value. Now consider the screen over here, and you will see the time formula here that's visible. Now click on the time option, and the time formula will give you, just open this time. So that formula in Excel dialog box will open, where you can put the argument values to obtain the return value. Now how to use this time in Excel sheet? Well, you will take an example to understand. For the same, you have been given hour, minute, and seconds. So what is going to be the result from the time function, decimal, default, and full form? Well, in the above screenshot, you can, you know, see that, or probably the Excel table. that three columns have been included, that is D, E, and F. That is this, D, E, and F. These columns have different formats, which shows the result generated from the time function. So consider the following point for better understanding. Let's say D. So column D cells are formatted with general format so that the result from the time function in decimal is displayed. Column E cells are formatted with the H, MM, and AMN PM default format. And this is how Excel automatically formats the result once you have entered time formula in Excel. And column F cells are formatted with HMMSS, so AMPM custom format. So this will help you seeing the full hours, minutes, and seconds. So over here, if I just write in decimal in the formula part, you'll just write time. The R will be A3, B3, and this. So it will show you 12 AM. Okay. Let's do Control D. You will get different time. Okay. So this is the way you basically, this is the default format. You can see this is the, if you just press this, this is the default format. But for the rest, you need to work on this. Like, you know, if I want in numbers, just to change this to numbers instead of time, just change this to numbers. What you can simply do is that, you know, copy this here, do Control D, you still have time. So change this to numbers. It will go to the number portion and the full format. Okay. Either you can use a function or you can directly take the time over here. So it will give a long format here. Okay. So this is how you do, you change various time formats. Now, Excel time function errors. Now, if you get any type of error from the time function in Excel, it can be any one of it. Like, you know, it has num error. Now, this kind of error occurs if the argument provided by you is evaluating a negative time. For example, if the supplied R is less than zero, okay, then it will show you num error. Then there is a value error. Now, this kind of error occurs if any argument supplied by you is non-numeric. Now, what things you should remember about time function in Excel is that first, a time on Excel allows you to create, you know, a time with an individual R, minutes and second component. Time on Excel is categorized under date and time function. Now the time on the Excel will return an decimal value that is between 0 to 0.99988, whatever may be the scenario. Now, after using this time on Excel, once you get the valid time, you can easily format it as per your requirements. If you have learned from this video, don't forget to like and subscribe this video for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.